In the movie End of the Spear, a 5-year-old boy is left fatherless when his missionary dad is speared and killed by a tribe in Ecuador.
If you guys would, please welcome Mr. Steve Saint.
Now in his 60s, Steve Saint still lives in Ecuador, but he came to the MTSU campus for an interactive discussion on his experiences with the people of Ecuador and his car flying technology.
We're right on the flanks of the Andes Mountains. In fact, where I live out in the jungles, you come out our way and try slogging through the jungles, and they call it the rainforest for a reason. We get about 30 feet of rain a year. That means that if you're in the valley, it's wet and muggy and muddy. If you're up on the ridges, then they twist and turn, and you're just going up and down. I mean, it's grueling.
Developing a vehicle that his friends could fly and drive in rugged terrain was Saint's solution to a world beyond roads.
They don't have access to medicine usually. They don't have access to power, which is one of the fundamental building blocks of every developed society. And you don't vote, or at least not in significant numbers. So what we do at iTech, really not only the flying car, but healthcare, equipment, tools, and training methods. And the training methods are really the more creative part than the tools themselves. Scary sometimes.
Gentlemen, we got company.
So how do you go from having your dad and his friends killed on the beaches in Ecuador and being a 5-year-old to then going back and living with and loving the same people who took your dad's life?
You know, there's a saying that says, hurt people hurt people. And there's a corollary to that that's forgiven people forgive. I have a real hard time with forgiveness.
Saint says growing up, he watched his mother and other widows of the 5 men killed continue to reach out to the tribe.
I mean, there was huge sadness. I mean, I don't mean everybody just smiled and went on with life. It wasn't that way at all. But I never, ever remember a single comment of animosity of any of those adults that were really my primary examples towards the Waodani. It never occurred to me that I should forgive them. I watched my mom, I watched my aunt, I loved them from the beginning. And
at 13, Saint was baptized by 2 tribe elders who had been converted.
2 men who were elders in the church, or the Wangungi Ponenga, coming, Jesus coming after ones, as we say in the tribe, who took us to baptize us. And my mom, they knew, wanted to see the place where my dad had been killed, so they took us down there. And then these 2 men, Kimo and Dewey, who you'll see in End of the Spear, decided to take us at Paniki there. They had killed my dad and his 4 friends and thrown their bodies into the river, and they took us into the same river and baptized us.
A pilot, Saint wanted to help those who aren't into mathematical calculations and headings to be able to fly like driving a car and to integrate the two.
So that you didn't have to go from one set of controls to fly to one set of controls to drive. Okay, now we're going to show a complete takeoff. The wing is already up, it's held in position, but now watch when he's... When we start to move, it inflates. It's a double canopy up there, open on the front, closed on the back. Now we're just taxiing right now to make sure that all the lines are clear. Now you'll hear it rev up and then watch. Okay, there it's revved up and it's off.
In addition to the prototype, Saint's iTech company has produced 4 of the so-called Mavericks, making it the highest produced flying car in history. MIT has a different version called the Terrafugua.
Ours is a flying car, theirs is a rotable airplane.
Saint says the Maverick weighs about 40% of what a smart car weighs, but with a 200 horsepower engine.
And it's very, very fast. 3.9 seconds, 0 to 60. It's as fast as a 540 horse Corvette. So the faster you turn the steering wheel, the faster that rack and pinion turns, the further you turn it. It feeds, that little sensor feeds what it's reading from the rack and pinion through an IC, an integrated circuit, that then tells 2 electric cylinders how to steer the plane.
Okay, Steve, what is your altitude?
Okay, Troy, I'm showing a little over
7,000 feet. I'm still climbing 250 feet.
When you look out your car door and you're 7,000 feet up, it looks really strange.
Strange for most, but not quite so strange for a missionary pilot and businessman who calls himself an Imagineer. Mike Browning, MTSU News.